Hey, John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got this question about blogging. So if you've signed up for my free blogging course, or if you haven't signed up, go check it out. I'll put the link in the notes in the description for this video, but I do offer a free blogging course, and I've got a lot of questions from that. Of course, here's one today. Hi, John. I've been following your email series on getting started on a blog. Actually, I haven't started blogging. I have a blog with Blogspot, and he posted here, after listening to your advice and others' advice as well, it seems that I really need to get a custom domain and really focus on a niche. I also write monthly posts for a blog at work. The organization that I work for was hit by the Good Idea Fairy over a year ago and decided to increase their social media exposure. Since I was somewhat of a consistent blogger, they recruited me in the effort. The original creators of this blog are long gone from the organization, and I've been left behind as the heir to the blog. So I don't bill the time I spend blogging for the organization, i.e. I don't get paid for blogging. Also, I think it takes away from my personal brand efforts because some blog posts that would do good for my personal blog end up going towards my company's blog. Once upon a time, I brought up the idea that maybe they should incentivize the blogging efforts. That way others would be more willing to contribute posts. I brought the idea to the marketing rep, and she brought it up with our financial director, but it went nowhere. That rep is now gone. To this day, I'm the only one who writes any posts. I've spoken with marketing about the direction and future of this blog. We can either be proactive or shut it down, but they pretty much take no action stance on being proactive. I've listened to how good you are at throwing solutions at problems, and I'm interested to hear how you would solve this problem. I don't mind contributing a post here and there, but I don't want to be the sole contributor. Please leave my name anonymous, since I wouldn't want my bosses to catch wind that I am questioning whether I should continue blogging for my organization. So I think that's probably anonymous. I definitely won't say your last name. So this is, and a lot of, just also to anonymize this further, a lot of people have asked this similar question. So I've gotten several people asking this because obviously a lot of companies are realizing that they need to start having blogs, and then they get their developers to blog for them. So here's what, I'll give you kind of my general high level philosophy. Don't work for free. You're working for free right now. Like, you're building some, and also along with this, don't build someone else's empire, right? When you're working for the man, and there's nothing wrong with working for the man, but when you're working for the man, you're making someone else rich. You're building someone else's empire. So you got to do what you got to do, right? You got to get by. You got to get a paycheck. A lot of times, not everyone can just go out and start their own business, right? So you work your 9 to 5, and I always say, work 40 hours, and that's it. Don't work 50 or 60 hours for someone else. Those other 10 or 20 hours, work for yourself. And so that's what really applies here, is I would say, if, I'm not saying that it's bad to blog for your employer, but you got to really weigh this out. Like, if you're blogging for your employer, are they either going to pay you? Sounds like they're not going to. Or is this going to really give you an opportunity to grow in the company, to advance up the ranks? And it doesn't sound like they're really appreciating you very much. They're kind of just taking you for granted. And I realize that they're not probably doing this with a malicious intent. They're probably not like, oh, look at Fernando who's writing blog posts for us, and we're not even paying him, and this is great. We'll just take advantage of this guy. They're probably not thinking that. But they're probably just letting status quo, just letting it go, and they're glad that you're running blog posts for them. But I don't really think, honestly, if it's taken away from your personal blog, I think probably the time that you spend would probably be better spent writing those posts for your own blog, building up your own name, marketing yourself, building up your own brand, rather than building up this company's brand. I don't particularly think that people should have really loyalty to companies, because companies really don't have loyalty to you in general. So economic hard times happen, they're just going to lay you off. So all that time that you invest and all that loyalty that you invest is going to be worth zero, zilch, nothing, right? So again, I don't mean to be negative. I don't mean to be derogatory. I don't mean to say slack off at work and don't do a good job. do a good job. Do, when you work for someone, do the best job that you can do and do hard work, but make sure that you get paid for it. Don't do things that you don't get paid for. Spend that time instead building your own empire, building your own blog, building, you know, marketing yourself. So that's the advice that I would give you, is if you continue to do the blogging for your company, then either make sure that they're paying you for it, or make sure that you think that this is gonna be a good investment, that sacrificing all that time and effort is going to advance your career within this company to enough to be worth it, to take that. You know, that's a risk, but you're the one who can decide whether or not that risk is worth taking. So anyway, good question. This is, like I said, a lot of people have asked this question. A lot of people are wondering about this. So I think you're definitely not alone. But it goes back to my general higher level philosophy of don't build someone else's empire, build your own empire. You know, you work 40 hour weeks and that's it. Like I'm a firm believer in that. And I don't like to see people, you know, wasting their time, not working on their own stuff. You know, you got to do your job, you got to do a good job. But beyond that, you know, your time belongs to you. No one owns you. This is not slavery. You know, it's not indentured servitude. Like, people don't own you because they've hired you for a job. Anyway, good question. Hopefully that helps. If you have a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, if you want to get more career advice and more life advice, for software developers, subscribe. Take care.